Hi and welcome! In this tutorial, we are going to create a hotkey button, a fully self-contained UI component that reacts to mouse clicks, keyboards, or gamepad input and displays the assigned hotkey right on the button itself. This script uses Unity's new input system, and we are also using TextMesh Pro to show the key label. I assume you have both installed and set up in your project already. We'll start by building a simple button in the UI. Create a canvas with an image object and style it however you want. Create a TextMesh Pro child object to serve as the hotkey label. Since hotkey indicators are usually placed in the top corner, click on the anchoring menu, then hold Alt and click here to quickly place it in the top right corner of the parent. If you resize the button now, the label stays locked in the right position. Choose a readable font. Bold fonts tend to stand out better, especially in smaller sizes. Uncheck Raycast Target in the label since it doesn't need to intercept any clicks, and finally, set its alignment to right. You might have to check later if the size of your text box is large enough. Some hotkey names are longer than others after all, but that is something you will only be able to test once everything has been set up. Since your button probably also includes an icon of an ability, you can add an image as another child. Stretch it to fill the button using the anchoring menu. This time hold Shift and Alt while selecting the Stretch to Fill option down in the bottom right corner. Add a few pixels of margin inside the Rect Transform component so your icon doesn't touch the edges. Add any placeholder icon you like, just for the reason that the box isn't empty. Once the image has content, Unity lets you pick Preserve Aspect Ratio, which is important to avoid distorted icons. Just like with the label, you can disable the raycast target on this image component too. In case your icon now overlays the hotkey label, change their order in the hierarchy to fix it. With your UI set up, let's head over to Writer. Our hotkey button is a script which inherits from Unity's selectable class, meaning it gets all the visual transitions and states you'd expect from a normal button. It also implements iPointerClick handler and iSubmit handler, so we can react to mouse clicks and keyboard or gamepad inputs. Inside the script, we have three main responsibilities. First, we want to respond to input from Unity's input system by subscribing to an input action. Second, we display the name of the assigned hotkey on the button's label. And third, we provide the proper visual feedback when the button is activated, either by clicking, pressing a key, or using a gamepad. We also expose a Unity event called onClick, which other scripts or components can subscribe to, just like Unity's built-in button. Behind the scenes, we store the latest used input device, a coroutine for resetting button state, and a cached wait for second for the transition duration. When the component is reset, we make sure that there's an image component on the object, since selectable needs it for the visual transitions. If it's missing, we just add one and assign it to the target graphic. Assign input action reference lets us switch out which input reference this button should react to. In start, we begin by calling the base start method from selectable, then subscribe to the performed event on the assigned input action. When the hotkey is triggered, our hotkey clicked method fires, simulating a button press. We also subscribe to a custom event from a separate input action handler script. This one detects when the user switches between input devices, like moving from keyboard to gamepad. Once we're listening to everything we need, we immediately update the label to reflect the current hotkey. When the object this script sits on is destroyed, we unsubscribe from all the events to prevent memory leaks and avoid lingering callbacks after the object is gone. The label update logic is handled in a method called setLabelText. If we have a valid input device and the label exists, we update the text to show the assigned button name. This is done using Unity's built-in method for converting input paths to human readable strings, like shift left or button south. We loop through the bindings in the input action, skip any composites, and only display the one matching our current device. Enjoyed the tutorial so far? Please give it a like and consider subscribing. There's a helper method called isCurrentDeviceBinding that checks whether the binding matches the current device. For example, if our device is a gamepad and the binding group includes gamepad, that's a match. Same goes for keyboard or mouse. Whenever the button is clicked, either through the pointer, keyboard, submit, or hotkey, the click method invokes the onClick event. The script also plays a visual transition to simulate being pressed, waits a bit, and then returns the button to its default state in case we are using a gamepad as our input device. This is all handled through coroutines and the selectable API. The input action handler's responsibility is to enable and disable our input references so other scripts can use them. In case these are used in different parts of the project, I try to bundle them all up in this handler. This makes it easier for me to troubleshoot in case things are not reacting as I had intended them to. Once your scripts are in place, head back to the editor. Create or open up your input manager system and add however many hotkeys you need. I will stick to the good old 1, 2, 3, 4 every good action bar needs. You create a new binding by clicking on the plus up here, giving it a memorable name, clicking on the plus next to it and adding a binding. Remember, you can set multiple bindings, for example if you want to support controllers or joysticks too. I have a checkbox to tick for the control scheme I want to use this button in. You can add more by clicking up here on all control schemes, then adding whatever else you might need. I recommend going with keyboard and gamepad. Make sure to save your changes. I lost count on how often I forgot to do this. Attach the hotkey button to your UI object. Assign the input action reference you want to trigger with it and connect the hotkey label to the TMP text slot. Also make sure you've added an input action handler script somewhere in your scene to keep track of active devices. Otherwise, your button won't know when to respond to input changes. Let's test it in play mode. I can click it and it behaves as expected. I can press a key on my keyboard to trigger it, and I can also press a corresponding button on my gamepad to do so. You now have a single compact hotkey button component that listens to user input, gives visual feedback, and shows the assigned hotkey directly on the button. You can prefab it, reuse it, and even plug it into your right-click menu for quick access while designing your UI. That's a tutorial you could watch next if you have about 5 minutes to spare. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like and consider subscribing. Have a great week!